When I was a student here, I actually had quite a few different interests. I found myself wanting to do art history and chemistry and study Spanish, which was the first draw that Carnegie Mellon brings you, that kind of mix of that arts and that science, that, you know, coming together. Being able to bring all of those skills to my current position, my different interests in art, in materials degradation, in Spanish. I often work with my Mexican colleagues or my production plant in Spain. Honestly, Spanish is being used quite a bit, and not only Spanish, but chemistry in Spanish, which is a whole nother language in itself. So it definitely challenges me quite a bit, but I find that all of the different interests that I had at CMU definitely bring something different, and my position actually brings all of those skills together. I would say two things. So one would be my systematic approach to lab work. Really trying to not only look at what experiments I need to do, but which experiments are going to get me to where I need to be in the most efficient way possible. Honestly, the scientist in me wants to do, you know, all of the experiments, eliminate all the possibilities, but we don't realistically have that time. So a lot of what you do is try and figure out what is the minimal amount of experiments that can eliminate my factors in order to get me to where I need to be. Also, at CMU, you have to learn to multitask. With a chemistry degree, you are in and out of lab, you're probably being pulled in many, many different directions, and you need to learn how to prioritize. I think that is key in my position and something that was definitely honed at Carnegie Mellon.